Welcome back, y'all. Welcome to the project.
Preston has been keeping himself busy post MasterChef with a brand new cookbook, and he joins us now to chat all about it. Your new cookbook, more, yeah, right? More. Vegetarian.
Yeah.
Except for this little sealed section at the back that's got meat recipes. It's like the sealed section in Cleo.
And there's nothing wrong with that, because I think a lot of people want to eat more vegetable based dishes, but then there's also someone in the family who might just want to add a bit of chicken in there or some lap chong sausage or... And so rather than having to make, like, two different dishes, you make one dish and then you flex in your extra protein if you want it.
Did you write this book after watching Game Changers by any chance?
No, I think Game Changers made that series after they watched this. Uh-huh. I've been working on this for 3 years now. It's been a really fascinating kind of experiment, because I had 3 months being a vegan, 3 months doing paleo, and just to get a handle on cooking veg in different ways, because normally most vegetarian cookbooks are pretty safe and they're pretty healthy and they're pretty kind of virtuous, and I'm not
interested in virtue.
I'm not the virtuous kind of guy.
I couldn't help but notice that a lot of these recipes are fried and covered in cheese. Is that because that's actually the only way to make vegetarian food nice?
You're right that you have gone to my favourite section, which is the fried section. Yeah. But you can braise, you can roast, you can use it in soup. So that's obviously healthy stuff. But there's nothing better. What is better?
Yeah.
What is better than making a tater tot, making a potato jam, and then slathering it with grated smoked cheddar, crispy jalapenos, and serving it?
No. What is? The audience is drooling.
With a dip made of smoked almonds.
But you know what might be better than that? Adding beef.
But I don't think that's the case. I think beef would just have it as a side dish for sure.
Beef is a side dish,
you know. Why do vegetables always have to be the thing on the side? Let's celebrate that beautiful whole cauliflower. And if you look,
vegetables across the size of your palm, and then a big beef all around.
Yeah.
You see, I think that way of eating is it's still there, right? Queensland, there's nothing they love more than a big hunk of cow that falls off the side of the plate. Ooh. But if you look at how people are eating in, say, cafes around Australia, there's not a lot of meat on the menu because it's expensive, because people are looking for a healthier way, because vegetables offer this incredible joy. I mean, how good is roast pumpkin in your Sunday roast?
That's my weakness. You
know, are there any recipes in here that would elicit or incite a reaction like this famous one from you?
Disgustingly good.
How many times have you used the term disgustingly good?
Once, then, never again. Because the thing you forget when you, and this is one of the things you forget when you do television, is when you do that in the studio, it's disgusting, disgustingly good. When it goes on TV, it goes disgusting and it runs in the promos for a week. And so everyone just goes, you're being really mean. And then it comes out, you're not being mean. They go, oh, that's really disappointing. You weren't mean.
It's the first year of that, by the way. Yeah.
How many plates did you smash? Did they make you do take after take after take?
It's Channel 10, one plate.
Oh, he's going swinging on the way out, isn't he?
No. We're fisting.
Oh, he's gone over to plate central.
I'm referencing fiscally responsible.
Right. The very first recipe is an avocado salad where, for some reason, you get sidetracked by talking about testicles. What happened there?
Because the name for avocado, the original name for avocado, hanging in when the conquistadors arrived in Mexico and they saw the avocado trees, the guys, the Aztecs went, oh, what do you call those? And they said testicles, because that's what we're called. Because the avocados were hanging in two, one slightly lower than the other.
I love avocados, isn't it?
All right, big nuts, enough about that. Hey, let's talk about a crime against humanity.
Yes.
Carrie attempted to cook one of your fine dishes, and I believe we have a shot over here. So that's how it's meant to look.
Oh, I saw.
On the left. And then...
Okay, hold on. I was making chicken chow mein, and then in the recipe you made me soak my noodles in corn flour and vinegar, and then they just went all...
It looks like a tuna dish that you've made.
No, that was just the noodles. They went like a...
Eaten the dish on the left, passed it through, and that's how it's come out.
The recipe actually says... Take the vinegar, the rice wine vinegar, and the corn flour and an egg white, beat it up, put your chicken in there, then leave your chicken to marinate that for 30 minutes, and then make your noodles by boiling them. So you see...
Oh, is that why my chicken was really bland?
Yeah, that's right.
My noodles look like that.
And this is the great thing about writing recipes. You could never underestimate that people may not follow every step one by one and they muddle stuff up.
Carrie's new book, Less, will be out soon.
Your promo, Disgusting, would just end at Disgusting.
Could have saved it with beef, I reckon. Anyway, there is the book.
Matt Preston's new cookbook, More, is available now. Would you please thank... It's great to have you back here. We love you, Matt Preston. Matt Preston!
Thank you guys. Awesome for having us to come.